The lawyer for George Zimmerman tells WESH 2 he may file what could be a precedent-setting motion in the case.
Mark O'Meara says he wants to decide whether witnesses in this case are in potential danger if their names are allowed to be out in the open.
WESH 2's Bob Keeling just spoke with Zimmerman's attorney, Mark O'Meara, and joins us live. Bob, O'Meara created this new website for Zimmerman and said they will not accept discovery evidence from the state until this witness issue is addressed.
Well, that's right, Jason, and it's interesting how O'Meara's position has evolved a little bit. Now, originally, he said he was more concerned about the media knowing these witness names and then getting to them and interviewing them and having more versions of their story out there, which could make his job harder. But on this new website you mentioned that went live this weekend, he says now that his concern over the witness is solely for their safety, so much so that he, for the time being, has turned down critical discovery evidence from the state until this issue can be ironed out. He's also created a new Facebook page to make his case through social media. Now, what he wants Judge Ken Lester to do is at least consider the possibility that the public's right to know about these witnesses, which usually is state law in Florida, should be set aside because of the amount of emotion and the potential for danger to this small number of witnesses in this case.
Absolutely. In a case with this high profile and the emotions in this case, anyone who says something positive to one side or negative to the other may be open to more scrutiny and safety concerns.
That as we're all aware.
Now, O'Meara did touch on this issue Friday in a court hearing, and Judge Ken Lester did seem to leave the door open to the possibility of going ahead and maintaining the witness's anonymity. On a separate issue, the state actually asked to muzzle Mark O'Meara through a gag order, which the judge turned down. The latest we have from O'Meara is he expects to be drafting this potentially precedent-setting motion this afternoon and could be filing it by the end of the day. We'll, of course, keep you posted on whatever develops. Reporting live at the Seminole County Courthouse, I'm Bob Keeling, WESH 2 News.